CBS presents this program in color.
You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
Television shows The Twilight Zone and Hogan's Heroes provide lessons as we tentatively emerge from the herd stupidity that led to the establishment of our state-run COVID religion in March 2020. An episode of The Twilight Zone comes to mind when contemplating the COVIDians who cling to their emotional support masks and other revolting, pseudoscientific, non-pharmaceutical interventions, supported by the public health police state and the coronavirus lockdown chorus in the media. In the Twilight Zone episode titled Eye of the Beholder, Janet Tyler undergoes plastic surgery to correct her deformity. The plot centers on Janet waiting in the hospital to see if her plastic surgery is successful. This is her 11th trip to the hospital for treatment, and she is desperate to look like everyone else.
How long?
Until they decide it's safe for your face.
I know. It's pretty bad, isn't it?
I've seen worse.
But it's pretty bad, isn't it? I know it's pretty bad.
During the entire episode, Janet's face is not shown, but we are constantly told how hideously ugly she is. The nurses, doctor, and other people who attend to her in the hospital also have their faces shielded. When the bandages are finally removed from Janet's face, we see that, in fact, Janet is beautiful, while the self-declared normal doctors and nurses are mutilated, deformed monstrosities.
Needle, please.
The lesson to be learned from this episode is that those of us who choose to be maskless are normal, while those who make our children wear masks for 7 hours a day and keep them from playing with their friends are grotesque and deformed, both mentally and physically. Infectious disease experts, working with teachers' unions, bosses, and supine politicians, continue to maim and deform parents and children in the name of protecting public health. We must be saved by these enlightened priests, rather than relying on our own sound judgment.
We must no longer permit the ugly to exist within our society. They must be removed. It is essential in this society that we not only have more, but that we conform to different foods.
Several days ago, one of the country's most prominent COVIDians, Mayor Bill de Blasio, announced that New York City public schools will fully reopen for in-person learning in September. Of course, he also stated that students and teachers will still be required to wear masks. Of course, anti-social distancing will also apply, along with other COVID mitigation policies to prevent normal childhood development. It seems that the unethical and deviant child experiment must continue for the indefinite future.
It's not fair, Doctor. I don't want to live among freaks. I want to live among normal people.
Look, Miss Tyler, we are not unsympathetic to your condition. Your presence here in this hospital attests to that. We're going to do everything we can for you, but you're going to have to be realistic.
Who are you people anyway? And what gives you the right to decide where I live and how I live?
I am just a doctor. Only the state can determine social policy. All we can do is follow the rules that they lay down for us.
But it's not fair, Doctor!
The second lesson from TV history comes from Hogan's Heroes. You may recall that a key character in this show was Colonel Wilhelm Klink, the bungling, vain, cowardly, and self-serving commandant of Stalag 13. In every episode, Colonel Klink proudly states that no one has ever escaped from Stalag 13.
Well, thank you for these magazines, sir.
Oh, please, Peter, it was not.
Oh, but it is. And in return, we want to renew our pledge to never embarrass you by even thinking of trying to escape.
But you're not embarrassing me. I understand these things. It's a soldier's duty to escape. Prisoners do it all the time. Why, only last week, 9 men from Stalag 20.
Ah, but Stalag 20 doesn't have a Colonel Klink.
Yes, yes.
Klink's maniacal and myopic focus on this one statistic makes him oblivious to the fact that Colonel Robert Hogan of the U.S. Air Force and his fellow prisoners of war are engaging in major sabotage and rescue operations against the Third Reich. Klink is even considered a success by his superiors in Berlin, even though he is clearly an abject failure. Klink's obsession with a single statistic brings to mind another source of government failure in the war on the coronavirus. Policy myopia, exhibited by our new bureaucratic masters, infectious disease experts, and their staunch supporters, politicians, who enthusiastically implement their recommendations and guidelines. Infectious disease experts have fully captured government in a clever coup d'etat, armed with faulty epidemiological models that have repeatedly shown themselves to be wildly inaccurate, and scientifically designed lockdowns and reopening strategies that always succeed. They work well with virtue signaling politicians who look for short-term fixes with instant and visible results to solve problems. Like Colonel Klink, the infectious disease experts have a maniacal obsession with cases, while simultaneously ignoring all the collateral damage, the death and destruction created by the quarantines, lockdowns, and reopenings themselves. The end result is that infectious disease experts and the politicians who implemented their draconian policies have succeeded in doing more damage to our economy and society, and yes, even to public health, than all the recent enemies of Western civilization combined. These officials also seem to have a single goal in mind, reducing the number of individuals who contract the virus. Such a single-minded approach is not consistent with an appropriate cost-benefit analysis of the consequences of their proposed actions. Despite the strong scientific evidence on the ineffectiveness of masks for adults and the harms inflicted by masking children, it's a puzzle as to why so many individuals continue to insist on their usefulness. Perhaps masks simply provide an emotional support mechanism for people who have been frightened out of their wits by the pseudoscientists and the profit-maximizing media.
Take this off of me!
It's time to ditch the emotional support mask and those who advocate its use.
She keeps complaining about her legs.
I'll be down to see.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, our leader.
The leader's speech is about to begin.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, I shall talk to you about glorious conformity, about the delight and the ultimate pleasure of our unified society. You recall, of course, that directionless, unproductive, over-sentimentalized era in man's history when it was assumed that dissent was a natural and healthy adjunct to society. You recall that during this period of time, there was a strange, over-sentimentalized concept that it mattered not that people were different, that this world could exist in some sort of crazy patchwork glued together in a fragmented society. We know now that that was wrong.